Promise me you won't be like that. Please, just be you. I like you the way you are.
Aw, thanks, sis.
I know a lord has many responsibilities, but you don't need to be like them.
I promise, I won't change.
Good, because I'd rather have a brother than a lord.
You'll have to have both, I'm afraid.
I'll try to be nice, but not weak.
Lord, you can do anything you want.
I suppose.
Well, not really.
Everyone will have to do as you say. So, I could have all the sweets I want.
If only it were that simple. It would be nice if someone did what I wanted for once. But Ethan will be a good lord. A proper lord.
That's not how it works.
Well, that's how it should work. You are the lord.
Yeah, but then you have people like Joffrey. You know?
Lord Ethan, you're needed in the Great Hall at once. Quickly, on your feet.
Get people who think that they can do whatever they want when they get into power. Nah. Not good.
What's the matter?
Lord Whitehill has arrived, unannounced, and certainly unexpected. He's come demanding justice.
Well...
Can't he meet with Duncan?
Shoot him in the face.
The Castellan.
Stay with us. Please, Ethan.
He's demanding an audience with the Lord. We really
I have
must
to
go.
It's your decision. You are the Lord.
If I were Lord, I would command Ethan to stay with his family.
Fine. If that's what's required of me.
Very well, then.
I have to go. I have to protect the family. And the people. I have to do what's right. Poor Duncan.
They showed up unannounced. Lord Whitehill is in a lather. I assume you explained to Lord Ethan why they're here?
A business with Garrett. I told him.
Lord Whitehill knows Garrett is a squire to this house. Or was, I suppose.
Is. Was. It makes no difference. The Whitehills were clearly in the wrong, so don't give him any satisfaction. Out there, you were decisive and firm. Now do it again with these bastards.
Let's not do something rash. Things are bad enough as it is.
I can handle
it. I can handle this, I'll be fine.
Well said, my lord.
I hope.
Now is not the time to anger Lord Whitehill any more than he already is. He's got 5 times as many men, and the backing of House Bolton.
All the more reason to stand up for ourselves. Only cowards and dead men rule over.
Have to be smart. You're uglier than I remember, man.
Lord Ethan, is it? My condolences for your father and brother. The late Lord Forrester was no friend to me or my house.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank him. Gotta be smart.
My only regret is I wasn't there to drive the dagger into his heart myself. I've been waiting for this day all my life.
I may be young, but I'm not so easily fooled. You're trying to rile me, but it won't work.
Young? You are that boy. Too young to know when you're in over your head.
We'll see.
And no bread and salt. What kind of fucking house receives a lord with no fucking bread and salt? You bloody ass.
Maybe if you announced yourself first.
No courtesies. I should have expected as much.
Calm yourself, old man.
Oh.
You little fuck. That's how you talk to a lord. You foresters have shit on us for generations. Well, now the Starks are no longer around to have your back, are they? We're the power in the north now.
Roose Bolton is the warden of the north.
Aye. And we've been his bannermen for 5 fucking centuries. You.
God. Wow.
Lord Ethan, you're losing control of this.
We all serve House Bolton now.
I'm not finished. Maybe if you hadn't been
fucking
greedy with the ironwood, things would have been different between us.
You squandered your share.
Our share was taken from us. We had no fucking choice but to harvest what was left.
What is it you want, Lord Whitehill?
Your man, the squire. We were minding our own business, keeping the king's
course,
as his lordship here said, when your man attacked us for no reason.
Hear that? Attacked for no reason.
Gonna be quiet.
It's your man who started it. How do you answer for your squire, Lord Ethan? He acted in your name. And you are the lord of this house.
I answer for yours.
People too, Lord Whitehill. Your men murdered his entire family.
You lost pig farmers, not soldiers. Soldiers worth 100 of their type. Where's the fucking coward who killed my men? I know he's here. What have you done with him?
I took care of it. He received his punishment and it's done. He's gone.
What? Gone? That was my justice to deliver, boy, and you denied me of it. I'm not leaving until I have my justice. Now bring me the coward who did it, or you'll answer to Roose Bolton.
Bring him!
What kind of fucking house is this?
A house of honorable men.
Ooh.
Lady Forrester.
You bellow like a wounded boar, Lord Whitehill. Have you forgotten your manners?
Yeah.
I mean no disrespect to you, my lady.
Yeah, you do.
During your losses and all. But this... this is not over.
It's over when my son says it is.
Thank you for coming, Lord Whitehill.
Ethan is Lord of Ironwrath now. By rights, his word is law here. If that displeases you, then I trust you can find the door.
That lad
may
be lord of this house. But Lord Bolton will have the final say. I'll send him a raven letting him know a Forrester man killed one of his own. That the new Lord Forrester lied to my face and denied me my justice. Then we'll see whose word is law.
I didn't lie to you.
Do as you like, Lord Whitehill.
Hey, I did what was needed. I actually punished the dude. Sent him to the wall.
You were brave, my son. But you'll need to be braver still when Ramsay Snow arrives to see you bend the knee. Prepare a raven. We need to send word to Mira in King's Landing at once.
King's Landing. Nice painting.
Although just a handmaiden, she has Marjorie Tyrell's favor. And Lady
Marjorie's
betrothal to the king may be enough to keep the Boltons at bay. If it's presented to her as it should be.
So now we're in King's Landing. We have to play the game. I hate the game. Ooh, Ironwood box. What have we in here?
Asher sent me this coin to remember him. What a strange place, Essos.
High Garden brooch.
It was very kind of Lady Marjorie to give this to me.
Oh,
it once belonged to Lady Elena.
Elena! The sassy. Oh, God. I love Elena. She's awesome.
Ethan made this for me.
Yeah, really good job. Alright, what's this? Look at. It's a letter. Alright, what's it say?
Father. Much excitement here in King's Landing for the coming wedding. Lady Marjorie has proven to be quite popular throughout the city. I do wish you and Mother could come, although I know it would be impossible under the circumstances. I miss all of you, and I look forward to the day you can.
Aww. I'm so sorry. Keep in mind also, I'm going to do my actions as best I can without trying to, have what happens in the show affect what's going to happen here. Like, I'm not going to use my knowledge of future seasons to affect this. Or I'm going to try my best to. Cool. So, we'll see how long that works. Now, let's see if they can get over here. Ooh, window.
King's Landing. I wonder if it's sunny at Ironwrath today.
I've never seen the ocean. I really want to.
A man by Lomas Longstrider. A gift from Roderick.
Aww.
I hope to see them all someday.
Well, you're not going to see Roderick, sadly. Anything else? Doesn't seem to be anything else I can do. Nice dress. Aha! Letter from Mum.
It troubles me to even ask this of you, but you must appeal to Lady Marjorie to intervene on our behalf. She is
okay, I can do that.
And can be a powerful ally, especially now when your family so desperately needs her help.
From what I remember, the decisions in this game get more and more difficult. So, it should be interesting.
One moment.
And who's here?
Oh, sorry, m'lady.
Hi.
I didn't mean to disturb you. I can come back later if you'd like.
No, it's fine. Come in.
He's the coal boy. He brings coal, fresh coals for the brazier. See?
Begging your pardon, m'lady, but you all right? If you don't mind my asking, you seem rather upset.
It's private. I'd rather not say.
Of course, m'lady. I didn't mean to pry.
Please hurry if you can. Lady Marjorie will be here any minute.
Of course, m'lady.
Don't need my problems being spread out through the by the servants.
I may be wrong. Seems like you do.
It's widely known that I work for Lady Marjorie.
I've seen you with her before. You seem like...
Oh, really?
I saw Lady Marjorie just this morning, outside the Royal Sept, talking to Queen Cersei.
Cersei?
That can't be good.
You seem to be having some sort of disagreement. I couldn't hear much, but...
You were eavesdropping?
No, not at all. I was just passing by, and I heard them arguing about House Forrester and...
House Forrester?
I thought you'd like to know. Forgive me if I was mistaken. I hope you're not in any kind of trouble. Most people don't tend to notice a coal boy. Not in King's Landing, with so many lords and ladies about. You see,
it's fair enough.
Sorts of things when people don't even know you're there. Good night, m'lady.
I get the feeling he's one of Varys, the spider's one of his little birds.
Lady Marjorie.
The Uncanny Valley is really weird in this game with people like this.
Come, there's something we must discuss.
You know, actors that are actually real. It's really weird.
From the day Hello. You arrived in Highgarden, I've thought of you more as a friend than as my handmaiden. A dear friend, in fact.
Thank you, my lady.
And you know how I feel about what's happened to your family. I feel your pain as if it were my own. What you've suffered is beyond imagining. And your poor family as well.
You're very kind, my lady.
Of course, Mira, but you must not despair. We will get through this together. You must understand there are limits
Yay.
To what I can say, especially here in King's Landing, now that I am to be queen. To have a handmaiden from the north whose family fought for Robb Stark, it raises questions at a time I can least afford. Cersei herself cornered me this morning outside the Royal Sept.
Kingsguard.
She mentioned
or gold cloaks.
The girl in
Same thing.
Service, and she painted you a traitor. She was very pleased with herself.
I'm not a traitor.
Of course not.
It's only an excuse to torment you, and by extension, me.
Okay.
She demands an audience. She wants an apology of some sort. For what, I don't know, but she's waiting for us now, and I promised I would bring you to her. I wouldn't ask this of you if it were not important.
I'll do as you ask, my lady.
I knew I could trust you. Humor her. Tell her what she wants to hear.
Okay, I can do that.
See if the Queen Regent is ready to receive us.
Hi.
You'll be fine. I know you will. You may feel one thing, but you must say another.
Alright, I can do that.
Good luck.
I'm a master liar. Not really, I suck at lying. I really do. I can't remember, did we ever see Joffrey in this game?
You can do this.
I don't fully remember. I also remember seeing Cersei. What's up? Oh. Woo! Is that Tyrion? Yes! Tyrion's awesome!
Aren't you looking lovely this evening?
Lord Tyrion. Your Grace? With your permission, allow me to introduce Lady Mira of House Forrester.
Neil.
Your Grace.
Get her what she wants. Yep.
Courtesies. Impressive. You may rise.
She is acting Queen Regent, so.
Is a northern house loyal to the king?
Are they?
I beg your pardon, Your Grace.
I wasn't talking to you. I want to hear from the girl.
Okay.
Is your family loyal to the king?
Of course.
Perhaps you should ask the new Lord Forrester.
He's not here, is he? She is. The girl can speak for her house.
House Forrester's loyalty to the crown never wavers, Your Grace.
I see. And yet, for centuries the Forresters have been loyal bannermen to House Stark. A house of traitors.
They were the wardens of the north. We all served at the pleasure of the king.
Clever girl.
Yeah. Made Tyrion happy.
Her own good.
The girl did say their loyalty was unwavering.
She has a talent for equivocation, yet I question what she really thinks. Is your house willing to swear fealty to your new liege lord, Roos Bolton?
Yeah, sure.
He is the Warden of the North, Your Grace.
He is. And I the Queen Regent and Tyrion the Master of Coin.
The girl has a remarkable talent for answering questions while in fact saying nothing at all.
I think Tyrion likes me.
Old allegiances are not easily abandoned. But now that the war is over, we must look to rebuild and forge new alliances. There are ships and shields to be built, and Joffrey will need a steady supply of ironwood for his armies. I'm told there are others who would happily serve that purpose, but I trust we can rely on House Forrester.
Of course!
Forrester Ironwood does seem rather unique.
To our mutual benefit, Your Grace.
And at the pleasure of your king. It would be a shame to see it fall into the hands of another house. I imagine you'd do almost anything to prevent that from happening, wouldn't you? Ask any Lannister, and they'd do whatever was necessary to save Casterly Rock. It would be unfortunate to see another house lay claim to what's yours.
There are limits, Your Grace.
Perhaps.
I'm gonna hit X.
But
crap.
Of your house faces potential ruin.
What would you have the girl do, Cersei? It's not as if she fought beside the Starks, wielding a battle axe for the Northern Army.
That would be interesting to see.
Raises an interesting question, I suppose. Can we truly blame those who end up on the wrong side of the war? Our dear Margaery here was betrothed to Rhaenyra Baratheon on the false assumption that he would one day rule the Seven Kingdoms.
Well, you're a bitch.
Can we fault her for her mistake? Should she be held accountable?
I won't judge her, Your Grace. I wasn't there. I didn't face her decisions.
Aren't you a delightful girl? If only one could flit through life without ever holding an opinion of their own.
If there's a point to this, I hope you find it quickly.
Loyalty can be such a hard thing to define. This city alone is filled with all sorts of ambitious opportunists looking to reinvent themselves, pretending to be something they're not. Who knows what lurks within their hearts?
Okay.
You are a girl from the north, here in service to Lady Margaery. One can only assume her interests are yours. Yet loyalty to a king, that must be absolute, beyond question.
Of course.
And if your loyalties were to become conflicted between your king and the very person whom you serve, what would you do then?
I'm sure she
would... Let the girl answer the question. Go on.
I would be true to the king, Your Grace.
Well said.
Of course.
I was beginning to worry you didn't have your priorities straight.
She is a threat to the crown, isn't she? The most dangerous handmaiden in all of King's Landing.
Oh, totally.
Senses this girl will say almost anything to get what she wants, which is not very encouraging.
Come on, Cersei, bring it. I know this game.
Of course, Your Grace.
Hi.
I'll walk you out.
Okay.
This may come as a surprise, but I met your father once, at the tourney at Lannisport. Even then he didn't trust Roose Bolton. We only spoke briefly, but your father struck me as an honorable man. You have my condolences for his loss.
Thank you, Lord Tyrion. That's very kind of you to say.
That certainly took courage, to so publicly declare your loyalty to Joffrey for all to hear. Poor Lady Margaery was humiliated, although Cersei seemed quite pleased.
Really?
It was quite the first impression. I, of course, found it all highly entertaining. My sister and I...
Can't talk about anything.
Differences. She takes great pleasure in her little charades. I take mine in thwarting them.
Yay!
We must find our amusements where we can. She threatened to give your ironwood to another house. It is the Master of Coin who decides such matters.
Oh, really?
The crown needs boats. Boats need wood, and I speak for the crown in this regard, not her.
What are you suggesting?
I suppose the crown could be persuaded to secure ironwood from House Forrester.
But...
Lady Margaery might not look favorably on such an alliance, and it would infuriate Cersei. Although what would be amusing for me might prove rather dangerous for you and your house. Are you willing to risk that?
Oh.
It may be far too dangerous. In fact, forget I even suggested such a thing.
I can't, sorry.
But it's a risk I cannot afford.
I admire your discretion. Now, if you'll excuse me, I promised Sansa I would join her for dinner tonight. Three beautiful bottles of Dornish wine await my arrival.
I hope we meet again.
Nothing would make Cersei happier. Until then, be careful.
Normally, I would probably 100% trust Tyrion, because he is... He is highly intelligent. But I can't. I've already made a deal with Margaery. Gotta keep true to my word. Hi.
How was it? Cersei has a way of looking at you as though you're nothing.
It went well.
Really? That's a relief. Cersei is known for being rather difficult. Lady Margaery has spent the entire day working on seating arrangements for the wedding.
Lovely.
And I are seated way at the back, here with the fourth cousins and the ninth born sons.
Lovely.
Sir Jaime. I wouldn't mind tarnishing that white cloak of his.
Sarah!
Oh.
It's true. And Oberyn Martell, the Red Viper. I'm told he has a paramour.
He is quite handsome.
And quite passionate, from what I've heard. Perhaps Lady Marjorie could make the right introductions. Who knows? We might meet our future husbands.
Woo!
Although, marrying a king, I can only imagine what that would be like. Would you marry Joffrey if it meant you'd become queen?
Gods, no!
He does have a certain look about him. And he's always treated Lady Marjorie well.
I don't want to be queen, no matter who I'd have to marry.
Don't want to be queen? You northerners. You'd make a perfect scepter. Well, I would marry him. Imagine the power you would have as Queen of the Seven Kingdoms. I might even allow you to
marry
your maiden.
But you'd have Cersei as your mother-in-law.
See, who else should we marry off?
She'd probably kill you on the wedding night.
Brienne of Tarth and Tyrion Lannister. What a perfect match.
Oh, that's just rude. Brienne of Tarth's awesome.
What are you doing? Well?
I'm sorry, my lady.
As am I. We shouldn't have been messing about.
This is not a game. It's a battle plan. Allies and enemies can be made with every move. Yet they say it is men who are powerful. The Queen was pleased by your display, Mira. I'm just glad it's over.
I'm putting my chips with her. I like Marjorie.
There's always someone to please or some perceived slight to smooth over. I fear it will only get worse when I am queen.
Once they know your true heart, the lords and ladies will have no choice but to love you.
Do you agree?
I wasn't paying attention. What?
Once you are queen, the lords and ladies will do their best to please you.
You learn very quickly. Your words to Cersei were brave, but I know you must fear what the Boltons might do to your family. I do appreciate your willingness to appease her, as difficult as it may have been.
Thank you, my lady. There's been something on my mind. Something important.
Ask for help.
I did have a favor to ask of you in return.
Whatever you wish to say, you can say it in front of Sarah. There are
she's a friend!
Between us.
It's about my family.
I trust her.
Oh. She's a friend. I trust her.
Go on.
Forgive me, my lady. I wouldn't otherwise ask this of you, but my mother insisted. It's about my family.
Ramsay Snow. What would you have me do?
My mother fears our family will suffer if Ramsay is left to do as he likes. She thought if a raven could be sent to the Boltons to let them know House Forrester has the protection of the crown. I know it's a lot to ask of you, and I wouldn't otherwise, but she insisted.
That is no small request, especially now.
I know, my lady, and I wouldn't ask this of you otherwise, but my mother has left me no choice. She insisted.
Joffrey knows only too well your family fought for the Starks, and now you would have me ask him to intervene. Is the situation that dire?
You can't, my
lady. Yeah, very dire.
King Joffrey won't like it. Just think how he turned on Lady Sansa. It is that dire, my lady. I fear for my family's safety.
If we had some teeth, we could protect ourselves from the Whitechapels. Or White Hills.
Cersei were to find out.
Don't let the Queen bully you. You have power over him, Lady Marjorie, as no one else does. Not even his mother. Ramsay Snow will arrive at Ironwrath within the week. I would never ask this of you if it weren't so urgent.
Please, Marjorie.
Very well. I'll make your request, but I cannot promise anything.
Thank you, my lady. I will send a raven to my family at once.
Siri, you better not betray me. I know quite a few poisons in this world that can really screw you up. Wolfswood. That doesn't sound very nice. What the hell? Yeah, no memory of this. Ah, great, lost my horse. What's going on? Oh no! I don't want to see this!
Shall we? Did you know my ancestors wore the skins of their enemies as a coat?
Oh, the Boltons. The flayed man.
Not my best work, unfortunately. I suppose I have full enough practice. But he didn't make it easy, what with all that bloody noise.
No, come back!
Cat. I thought he'd never stop.
As my father likes to say, a naked man holds few secrets, but the flayed man holds none.
Pity he didn't know your father is the Warden of the North.
He does now.
Ah, flaying, such a...
How much further is it? These foresters.
Day, my lord. Two at most.
Oh, they're gonna arrive sooner.
My lord?
Shh. Listen. There.
Don't move.
Hear that? I know I heard something.
Stay still. If I run, they'll definitely know I'm here. If I stay, they may overlook me. Because I am low to the ground, it is dark. By a tree.
We've wasted enough time already.
Oh. So either a few days have passed between Mira and Garrod, or Ramsay left early. Hope that that raven arrives soon. Yeah, the flayed man is the Bolton symbol, and the Starks outlawed flaying. But now the Boltons are the leaders, or the Wardens. Yeah. Oh, that's bad.
Lord Ethan. As
so,
I was saying.
Hey, Maester.
You are young. And there are those within these walls who are uncertain of your leadership. But 300 generations of Forester Lords stand behind you.
That's a lot of generations.
Lord Gerhard the Tall, who founded our house, and your grandfather, Lord Thorin the Bold, who seized back the river valley from the White Hills.
What did they call my father?
Lord Gregor the Good. He was fair and wise.
And what would they call me?
That
good question.
Is for you to define as the new lord. These were your father's people to lead and protect, and now they're yours. But your father did not bear this responsibility alone. He and every Forester Lord before him chose one man whom they trusted above all others, the Lord Sentinel.
Forrester traditions demand that a new Lord Sentinel must be chosen.
Alrighty. I'm gonna make Duncan Sentinel. Alright, what's wrong?
I was only trying to survive.
Lord Ethan. Miss.
Who's this man? What has he done?
This craven is a deserter and a thief.
Oh boy.
This house is doomed! We all fucking know it!
Quiet, thief. Eric was supposed to be guarding our weapons, but instead we caught him stealing them.
Oh, dude.
Two shields and three spears.
Is what Sir Roiland said true?
Yes, my lord. I fled. We should all flee.
It's not stealing if you're taking what's yours by right.
He speaks true.
Yeah, it is.
Family to feed. They're not two coins to rub together since Lord Gregor left us to rot here. Where's our pay? Our share of bread and wine grows smaller every day.
Leave the poor man alone.
Lord Ethan, I know these words are hard, but they're honest. This house is falling. We'll never survive the coming winter. Most of us won't even live to see it.
Calm yourself.
The time for calm passed with the late Lord Forrester. Now there's only chaos.
You'll address him as Lord. Lord Ethan, you must decide the punishment. Lord Gregor always took a thief's fingers. Three of them.
Now may not be the time for harsh punishment. The men are on edge as it
is. Men need to know they cannot do whatever the fuck they please. Their Lord will not permit it.
He can send oh, him boy. Oh, this isn't good.
I will decide.
Send him to the wall. Take his fingers.
He's a thief.
If you punish me, you'll be punishing an innocent man. It will be an injustice, my lord. Please, my lord. My family depends on me.
Send him to the wall.
Sentence you to the wall. Where you will join the Night's Watch.
No, please, my lord! My family, without me, they'll die!
I could have taken your hand. Or killed you. Ned would have killed you.
That was certainly unpleasant, but a lord must mete out punishment when it's due.
Not just yourself, of course.
It's a lord's duty, so I did it.
You heard what the thief said. I expect this sort of thing will happen again. But a sentinel can
probably
help you in the face of disloyalty. You need someone you can trust by your side. Someone you can rely on, no matter the circumstance. Possessing wisdom.
Who do you think I should choose?
There are two capable men for the role. They both want the job. Neither thinks very highly of the other.
How do I decide between them?
Talk to them. Solicit the opinion of people close to you.
Here. I can't choose the maester because of his position as maester.
The badge of office.
I think.
Tonight is your first small council meeting. It would be wise to bestow this bracer upon your chosen sentinel then, to show that you are decisive and in control of this house. Your sentinel will wear this for all to see.
I understand. I'll do it now.
Come speak with me when you're ready to convene the small council, my lord.
Okay. I like the bracelet. It looks cool. All right. What's this? Maester Tower. Okay. Let's take a look at the food. See how our supplies are going.
Our provisions are rather low, my lord. I made the count again, just to be sure.
Has anything gone missing?
No. Doesn't look that way. Seems Eric was the only one to resort to thievery. But I'm
good.
Still worried about our story.
Well, not good, but...
We couldn't withstand a siege, my lord. If the Boltons or the White Hills cut us off and wait us out, we'd only last a fortnight. But there are steps we can take. In the past, we've demanded food from the small folk to replenish our stores. We can do it again, if you'd like. We've done it before in desperate times. The last long winter, my family had to give all our pigs to the house.
If that's what's necessary to keep the house safe, then we must.
Aye, a hard choice, but it's what has to be done. I'll see to the arrangements, my lord.
Okay. Alright, so he's a pretty good man. Very calm, even-tempered. Whereas, the other dude, he is very, very brutal. Curious what's up with this tower. Has to be a reason for it, so I'm checking it out real quickly. Alright. Probably just an overview of the area. Okay. Let's just do the small council thing. Actually, let's talk to the other dude. He may have something we need to do as well.
You're all worthless and weak.
Ooh, hello. Hey, Whirlin. Fuck
to. Swing left. Parry. Wrong. I didn't know dogs could hold swords.
A word?
Of course, my lord.
I have many decisions to make, and I wanted your advice.
What's our defenses?
Our defenses? Are these men ready for what's coming?
This lot, ready? No, but they will be. We post anyone who can hold a spear along the parapet, up where they won't get much scrutiny. And put our meanest, nastiest-looking brutes front and center. That'll show Ramsay we're a force in our own right. You've got to project power, especially when you're weakened.
Thank you, Sir Roy.
Kinda.
I'll let you get back to training these men.
Thank you, my lord. And I'll be sure to watch out for more deserters. After today, I suspect there'll be more to come.
Yeah, probably, sadly. Don't worry about that. Hey, Roland, how you doing? Orion.
Careful. Keep at it and you won't have much left. Something to pick your teeth with.
No, Ethan. Look at this. All good swords have a name. I call mine Two Brothers. I carve this to give me strength.
Oh, awesome.
So I remember. I mean, I could never forget. But, oh, you know, don't you?
You honor Roderick with this. He was a strong one.
He was. Yeah.
Aww.
Someday, I'll have a real one. But not like that one. Only a lord could have that sword.
You'll have a good sword. I'm sure of it.
I watched you today. I saw what you did to that man.